And now, a Golfmas carol brought to you by Golfsmith.
On the 12th day of Golfmas, my Golfsmith gave to me 12 Pro V1s, 11 Under Armors, 10 Golf Tech Blasts, 8 Bertha Iron, 7 Golfsmith gift card, 6 Garmin watches, a 5 Iron 2.
Come celebrate Golfmas, happening right now only at Golfsmith.
These 2 Cleveland wedges and a tap-in birdie on a par 3.
Golfsmith, anything for golf.
I'm Chris Wall. Since taking Andro 400, I have dropped 45 pounds. I'm sleeping better. My knee pain went away. I've had some lower back issues, and I've noticed that that went away. The radio ad says it attacks belly fat. Well, let me tell you, it did. I've lost 6 inches.
So, guys, if you'd like to get similar results, try Andro 400, the safe, inexpensive way to boost your testosterone. Go to andro400.com or call 888-400-0435. 888-400-0435.
I'm Major George Patterson from the Salvation Army. Please stop by our family store at 120 Northwest 10th Street in Ocala, where on Wednesday you have a 50% off clothing and bric-a-brac. On Friday, 25% off furniture and large appliances. And on Saturday, stop by to our yard sale from 8:45 to 11. Donations can be made by calling 352-732-4469 and we'll pick it up. Funds from the store go toward the services that we provide in Marion County.
Here's what you may have missed on the John Tesh Radio Show.
Scientists recommend we eat processed meats rarely, which means one serving or less per week of bacon, salami, sausage, or deli meat. Don't troll for dates late at night. It's the online dating equivalent of drunk texting somebody from a bar. When we interact with a friendly animal, our muscles instantly relax. That's because animals are passive and they are never judging us.
Intelligence for your life on the John Tesh Radio Show. Don't miss this stuff.
Hey, Matt, I know Sunrise Automotive does auto stuff, but I need some tires for my truck. Can you recommend someone?
Yes, I can. We do that.
No, I mean, I need them installed and balanced and all that.
Yep, we do that.
Well, my son needed his windows tinted.
Yep, we do that,
I need my seat replaced.
Yep, we do that, too.
I need a new roofline, a new spoiler, and a new truck.
Yep, we can even do that, too.
Okay, I get it. I suppose you can also do a radio show, too, huh?
Well, as a matter of fact, join me every Monday at 10 for auto repair with personal care here on The Source.
Of course you do.
Good credits, bad credits. It's none of our business because we're not an auto dealer. We're not a bank. We're not your mother. We're OcalaForSale.com, Marion County's marketplace for cars, trucks, and SUVs. We've got thousands of sellers standing by to take your call. No middleman. But hurry, don't walk, don't run. Just sit down and log on to OcalaForSale.com.
Prices and inventory change daily. Offer does not include dealer upcharge, undercutting, rust proofing, factory surcharge, or delivery fee. See website for details.
Do you have areas that have started sagging or drooping? Is what you're looking at not quite the same as it was years ago? Are there enhancements you've been putting off? Is there serious damage you need fixed? Then call on us, Damage Control Services. When your roof is sagging and the drywall is drooping after a storm, or your home just needs some enhancements, from damage repairs to new construction, Damage Control Services is here to help.
Hi, I'm Leah Caruso with Strive Rehabilitation, inviting you to join me Thursday at 11 a.m. for Health Matters. Ocala Health and Strive have teamed up to bring you the latest information on good health services available to you right here at home. This vital information will help you make informed decisions about your health. So don't forget to join me here at 11 a.m. Thursday. It's news you can use from Ocala Health, Strive, and your friends here at WOCA.
Ocala's information station, 1370 WOCA.
Ocala! Damage control.
All right, for all of Joe Reichel's fans who enjoy the close-up on the videos, I'm sorry, I can't figure out how to do the close-up right now.
No close-ups today.
We got so you see the top of my head and Joe. And I normally zoom in on you, but I just can't figure out how
to
zoom in.
The top of your head should be right about there.
You're close. Yeah. Yeah. It looks weird. Looks like I got a giant head. Well, I do have a giant head. Come on, Joe. How you doing?
I'm good.
Yesterday, there was a fire in my neighborhood.
Really?
Yeah. And everybody the okay? fact it was in the news, well, the dog died.
Oh.
Yeah, I know. And they were giving it CPR, apparently. But the good news, I know it's sad when the dog dies, but the good news is the people weren't there. And the fire department got it. It's a mobile home, news. By the way. To me, not an expert, but it looks fixable.
Probably is.
I don't know.
And that's the great thing about the fire departments and all of the training that they go through. They are able to respond quickly, and most of the time, they're able to put the fire out before there's
isn't that amazing?
damage that's unrepairable. So, I mean, I went to one this week over in the northwest side of town. It's been... this was the fire happened back in September. She hasn't got it repaired yet, but basically two rooms of a mobile home are destroyed, and then the rest of it is fixable.
So. Oh wow! My sister was married, so this is my brother-in-law.
Okay.
My sister's passed away, so she's. I don't know if he's still my brother-in-law, but anyway.
Well, I would think so.
He either is or was my brother. But anyway, he called me on the phone. And he said, "Hey,
do you like him?"
Yeah.
Okay.
But he said there's a fire near your house. I said, "Oh my gosh!" So I went over there, and everything was fine. However, I was sitting there listening to the firemen, and I heard one say he busted the window, and I guess the smoke just came out of there,
right,
like a gusher.
And that's the thing, you know, when the fire department gets there, typically they'll bust the door down, they'll bust some windows, and that's to get the smoke out of the house. They don't, and there's a lot of damage that's caused whenever this happens.
Yeah.
By the fire department. I mean, sometimes they even cut holes in the roof in order to get the smoke that's in the attic area to escape. Like I said, there's a lot of damage that's caused by them, but this is to minimize the amount of damage that's caused to the house. It gets that smoke out. It gets the fire out, helps them to, access different areas quicker and easier. So, that's why after a fire, typically our job when we come into a situation like that is to secure and board up the place. So,
what do you do about the smell? How do you get the smoke smell out?
Well, that's, through the process of cleaning and, get rid of the soot.
I think you explained this once before, but I'm just...
Well, there's several different options in order to get rid of the smell. First of all the soot needs to be removed. So you need to do the cleaning process.
Right,
you need to get all of that taken care of, get all the contents out. In order to get the contents, like your textiles, those all need to be professionally taken care of typically, and that's the route there. But as far as the structure itself, once all the soot is cleaned, your drywall can be painted and things like that if it's not burnt.
Right.
Anything that's burnt needs to be removed.
Yeah.
Because that smell you'll never be able to get rid of.
Yeah. And you'd have a phone call. Thank you for waiting. By the way, good morning. You're on there with Joe Reichel.
Yeah. Good morning, Joe, and happy holidays.
Thank you.
Say, when a person's going to re-roof now, what is the difference between like a 30-year roof, a 50, or whatever? Are you getting more roof, a thicker roof, or are you really getting more for your money when you pay for a more expensive roof?
That's a great question, and the answer is yes. That is explaining the life expectancy of that material. Typically, what you're talking about is a shingle. When they have the 20-year or 30-year or 50-year shingles, that gives you that much wear time. That is, a warranty that they have with that, and gives you the that's the life expectancy, so to speak. So, if anything was to happen within say 10 years or whatever, they would have a manufacturer's warranty on that, on the materials.
Okay. What is your feeling on what they call an architectural style roof?
Well, if you're going with a shingle, it's either an architectural style shingle or a three-tab shingle.
Right.
Your three-tab is an older style, and that was what used to be on houses, all the houses, and it just looks like an individual tab. So the architectural is more of a It sort of kind of looks like a like the old cedar shake roofs. That's the look that it gives you. A different style, different size tabs there, and you really can't see where one tab is or not. And they have like a shadow effect to them typically, and they're a much prettier prettier shingle, in my opinion. They are a little more costly, and typically those are the ones that have the longer lifespan.
Would a shingle like that be, like down here in Florida where you got wind problems with hurricanes and stuff, be a little more stronger than the three tab?
Well, there isn't individual tabs, so I would think yes. But those tabs, whenever you install that, those shingles are installed, they have a like a tar strip in the back, and that seals once it gets warm. That will seal to the roof, and typically those will stay in place. As the roof gets older, though, that tar strip will sometimes dry out, and that's when you get a gust of wind or something like that with the storms, and it'll get under there and peel off a single tab or a couple tabs on a roof. But so typically your architectural shingle is a little more wind resistant, I would say.
Is it ever feasible to roof over an existing roof?
Well, sometimes it is economically cheaper in the initial stage, but it typically it will cut down the life expectancy of the product that you're putting over it. So.
Oh.
That's one thing to be concerned about. That's not necessarily something that I would recommend. People used to do it quite a bit, not so much anymore.
Yeah, I know up north, right where I came from, you see that done quite a bit, re-roofing over existing roof.
Right.
But down here, not so much.
Well, and that's because down here we do get a lot more of the direct sunlight, a lot more of the intense rays from the sun, so that will cut down the lifetime, the life expectancy of your roof. So you're dealing with the elements, and it's kind of a little bit harder on them down here, a little harsher.
Okay, well, thank you very much, and have a great holiday.
Thank you for the questions.
And the questions are important to us. If you want to call in, the number is 622-9622. Joe Reichel is here. And, I was mentioning yesterday there was a fire. I guess you would consider it a small fire, but it's major because the people can't live there anymore.
Yes. These disasters like that, and until you go through them, you really don't understand. And everything that in that home now smells like smoke.
Right. And when they open the door, this is a mobile home. So when they open the door at the other end of the mobile home, which is not that far away, but you could see the top part of the door
above that door, all black.
Was all black. The bottom part, which kind of re-emphasizes the whole rule of drop and roll when you have a fire. If I guess you get down to the bottom, that's where it's less smoky.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and get out of there. Yeah,
exactly.
All right, we are up against that time where we need to take a little break. So we'll take a little break and we'll be right back. If you have a question for Joe, this is a good time to call. You'll be on hold about 2 minutes if you call right now. 622-9622. We'll be right back. I think. Well, maybe not.
Technical difficulty?
I don't know what's happening here. All right, I can't get it to force play. All right, we'll just count down. We'll be there in a minute. We'll be right back. I can't do something when it's not working. Here we go. Now, here we go. We'll be right back.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Safe boating is no accident. Our day began with some fog. It'll be warm today with variable cloudiness, high 77 to 81. Mostly cloudy tonight with a shower late, low 66 to 70. For tomorrow, Christmas Eve, cloudy, breezy, warm, and humid with a couple of showers and thunderstorms, mainly in the afternoon, the high 78 to 82. For Thursday, Christmas Day, sunshine returns, cooler and less humid, the high 66 to 70. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm meteorologist Joe Lundberg.
Let's face it, nowadays it can be hard to find American-made products, and that's something that Cabinet Sales of North Florida is well aware of. That's why they're an authorized dealer of Wellborn Cabinetry, family-owned and American-made since 1961. Cabinet Sales of North Florida is your answer for complete turnkey kitchen remodels and whole house cabinetry. Their cabinets are finished with solvent-based enamels for a long-lasting finish that's second to none. Available in an incredible selection of door styles and colors to choose from to turn your dream kitchen into a reality. In-house design and drawing services are available. Come by and see our displays for yourself at the Floors of the Villages, 3935 County Road 216 in Oxford, or Exquisite Design Kitchen and Bath in Bellevue, right across the street from the Bellevue Library. So whether you're looking for bookcases, kitchen, bath, or outdoor kitchen, Cabinet Sales of North Florida is your one-stop source of quality cabinets. For a free estimate, call 352-427-2647. That's 352-427-2647. Cabinet Sales of North Florida.
Your home is safe, or is it? AA Lock, Dock, and Security. The name has been a staple in Ocala since 1985. Do you have the right equipment in place to have peace of mind when you are at home or away? AA Lock, Dock, and Security has the right people to install and monitor your home or business. Call today for a free on-site security analysis. Call 867-1965. AA Lock, Dock, and Security, 219 Northwest 10th Street, 867-1965.
Your weekends are getting a little retooled.
Swear to God, not making a joke.
Check this out.
New shows? Check.
We are Fox Sports.
Some new talent?
Check.
Let's welcome the guys.
Let's get it going.
Arnie Spanier.
Unbelievable.
TJ Reeves.
This is what you get.
Your weekends are on fire.
Because that's how exotic it is.
We are Fox Sports.
One of the most common questions those nearing retirement are asking, will I outlive my money? Retirement questions like these and many more will be answered every Saturday morning at 9 a.m. on Planning for a Better and Safer Retirement with hosts Francois and Julian Cozenet. Francois and Julian will help you put your retirement puzzle together. Catch Planning for a Better and Safer Retirement Saturdays at 9 a.m. on Ocala's News Talk, The Source 96.3 FM and 1370 AM.
All right, 12 minutes now before 11 o'clock. Joe Reichel is here from Damage Control Services. And, of course, Joe's mission is to repair things that have been broken, either by nature, by disaster, by who knows. Maybe somebody got angry and punched a hole in the wall. Yeah, I'm sure that has happened. Have you ever had that kind of a job? Hey, my husband punched a hole in the wall.
We've been able to fix stuff like that. But typically, you know, we'll get someone that does drywall repairs for something like that. But we fix
that's
it.
That's kind of a do-it-yourselfer.
But, you know, but we have had homes that like, tenants have vandalized or foreclosures that have been, you know, destroyed.
What is wrong with people when they do that?
I don't know.
Yeah, that's not your job, right? Your job is to fix things. So do you have a lot of people calling you for do-it-yourself help? Like, what kind of tools to use?
Not so much.
No?
No. Most of the time when people call us, it's, hey, we need this done.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
I need this taken care of. So, like this morning on my way here, I got a phone call for a bathroom that has a leak of some sort in it, and it's been wet for an extended period of time. And
oh, really?
Yeah.
So wooden floor?
No, it's a tile floor, but the walls, the drywall and the walls are wet.
Oh, okay. So they're going to go. If you don't fix them, they're going to rot away, right?
Well, it'll be a while before it rots, but, I mean, you will end up with mold behind there and then the odor. So.
Mushrooms.
Right.
Mushrooms grow from that stuff.
Mushrooms, yep, lots of fungus. So, I mean, we've got that one. I've got one that was a house for sale. Another call this morning was a house for sale, and the realtor called me, and he said, hey, the homeowner lives up north. He's selling it for his parents, and, you know, it has cabinet damage, and it had a leaking pipe. So they thought it was a water heater leak, and it's not the water heater. It's a supply line to the water heater that's leaking. So.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
Does that take a lot of doing before you figure it out? I mean, it must, like with every, like a doctor, you always have to diagnose the problem.
Need to diagnose the problem. So you go in there and you figure out where it's, you know, a process of elimination. Sometimes it's just a matter of finding that pipe or finding where the leak is from. If it's in a wall, we can cut the drywall away or whatnot. One I had was a leak in a house that I, you know, there was no plumbing visible, and it was a bedroom.
Right.
By going outside, found out that there was a hose bib out there, so we were able to, you know, realize that the hose bib was leaking, able to fix it, and go from there. So,
what's a hose bib?
The hose bib is where your hose attaches on the outside of your house, typically.
Okay.
That's
okay.
A, like a spigot.
Right.
Outside spigot. It's called the hose bib.
Oh, I didn't know that.
I didn't realize I was using a buzzword.
Oh, really?
Sorry. Yeah.
Well, no, maybe. I mean, maybe
I thought that was something that was a common term. Yeah, that's the outside water spigot on your house where you would attach a hose. It's called a hose bib. So if they're dripping, they're leaking, you know, typically you'll need to get that replaced or get it fixed because it could be causing a problem inside the home as well.
If you're living up or downhill, I should say, from a house that has a leak like that, that could be, I guess, coming through the ground to your house or not really?
It would have to be a substantial leak. And that's, you know, I got called about a house, and it wasn't a job of ours. It was another restoration company, one of our competitors in town. I guess they got the call for it, and the contractor that they called in called me and was asking me about it. What happened was the water was leaking in this house. The lady wasn't home, and the water company called and said, hey, you've used X amount of gallons in the last three weeks.
Wow.
Thousands of gallons of water had leaked out into this house, and what it was an upstairs bathroom. So over a period of 3 weeks, it had been leaking substantially, and so unfortunately in that situation, the entire house needs to be gutted, and then, you know, a mold remediation done, gut it, mold remediate it, and then work on putting it all back together. Yeah. So,
and when you say mold remediation, I know what you mean, but is that something you could do yourself?
You could, you know, but I mean, the guys are on one this morning, for example, and it was, what happened was, it's condos. I think I talked about last week, the job that we got, and they're starting it today. A neighbor's, in a set of condos, and the neighbor's water heater was leaking, and it leaked into the neighbor's unit. They didn't know it was leaking, and they used it as a vacation type home, so a weekend getaway. So when they went there, it's wet, there's mold everywhere. In a situation like that, all of the contents need to be thrown away. We need to do a containment unit, and we need to treat it. A typical homeowner in a situation like that would probably be overwhelmed. If you had a small area that's just, say, under your cabinet in the kitchen that was leaking and you had some mold, you could cut that drywall out, bag it, get it out of your house, probably wouldn't have a problem. But when you're dealing with an extensive amount of area, once you start into that and demolishing the area that's wet and getting rid of it, when you disturb that, it's going everywhere in the house. So that's why we set up a containment system in order to keep that confined to one area. Once we do the clean out, we can treat that area and make sure that that mold growth, everything, all of it is dead. We'll put in a, you know, in order to purify the air, exchange the air and get that all, HEPA filters in all of our system, get that all cleaned out, and that way you won't have a situation where it will come back.
So to say there's no such thing as a little leak wouldn't be true, but there's no such thing as a leak that doesn't need to be fixed. That's got to be true. Even if it's a small drip, eventually it's going to cause enough problems.
Well, it'll cause damage. Small drips need to be fixed just like the rest of them.
Yeah.
So it will, unattended, it will continue to cause problems. I got a text message on the way here, and a friend of mine says, hey, I've got a roof leak, and it's leaking in the master bedroom, and it's got a spot in the ceiling.
Oh, no.
It's a small leak, but unattended, that continues to get wet. Over time, that insulation in there, everything's getting wet.
Oh, yeah.
The drywall will get saturated to the point where it will fall down. So even though it's a little leak now, it's, you know, always better to fix it. If you start, you know, if you're looking in your home and you see a spot in your ceiling, where it's got the brown, like a water stain on the roof, you want to address that, because left unattended, you know, just like the earlier caller who was asking about shingles, you probably have an issue on the roof somewhere. And right now it's a small issue, but if you don't take care of it, it will create a definite problem.
Yeah. I remember working at another radio station, and we actually broadcast from the transmitter site. And
right?
The transmitter was basically an old shack. And long story short, the rain started coming through the roof. And it was pulling down the ceiling tiles. So they were getting wet, and they were just falling in. And so I got up on the roof with this big, thick piece of plastic, and just did a temporary until somebody who knew really what to do could come, somebody like
right.
yourself. Yeah.
And that's the thing. It, you know, might be best just to tarp it in until repairs can be made, like putting a new roof on or actually finding it. We get calls all the time when it is actually raining out, and they, you know,
yeah, remember all the tarps? Were you here in 2004?
Yep.
Yeah, all the tarps. Everywhere you looked, there was tarps.
The state flag.
Yeah.
The tarps.
Right, it was the state flag, yeah.
Yep. So, you know, and that's where, you know, I get a call not too long ago from the Literacy Council. Summer called me and said, hey, we've got a roof leak. And
In
the new building.
Oh, no.
And what it was one of the ceiling tiles, acoustical ceiling, was basically saturated and about to fall down. And when I went in there and I took that tile down, because it has to be replaced anyway, realized it was an air conditioning drain line that had separated, and that's what was dripping. So
oh, wow.
we see that more often
oh,
than
wow.
not. You know, people think it's a roof leak and it's really
right.
you know, the air conditioning supply right. lines. I've right. seen several of those in different buildings.
You know, the other week right now it's feels like Florida is supposed to feel, but the other week it was cold enough to actually have frost.
Yes.
And I woke up, took the dog outside, and I thought, wow, it sounds like it's raining, but it's beautiful out here. What it was whatever ice had built up on the roof.
Yep, was dripping.
It was starting to melt and
yep.
drip, yeah.
Yeah, and that's the thing. I mean, this time of the year, a lot of people are using space heaters and whatnot, and you want to always be careful, definitely be careful if you're using a space heater with this cooler weather. People ought to, you know, especially get up in the morning, just warm up their bedroom or warm up the bathroom
right,
or whatnot.
Right,
and,
right.
you know, make sure that you're, you know, using safety precautions whenever you're doing that, because those are and don't leave them plugged in when you're not home.
Don't leave them plugged in. I saw a desk heater.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know where I saw it. It's one of the stores around here. Just a little tiny, maybe it was Walmart, a little tiny thing. Put it on your desk.
There you go. Well, I mean, those are great, but, you know, there again, a lot of people, you know, if you don't unplug it when you leave, that's,
right, right.
you know, it's left
better
there.
Better get a sweater. Just wear a sweater.
Or put socks on.
Put socks, nice right, like red socks.
Red socks, yeah.
You can get them for free if you donate blood at LifeSouth. That's how we got him yesterday.
There you go.
Well, Joe, thank you so much for what you do for all of us to help us understand this. And my recommendation for everybody is to simply get one of the magnets that you have, one of the business card magnets, put it on your refrigerator, because you don't want to ever use Joe's number. But if you let me put it up to the camera. If you have one of these.
There you go.
Then you will have it on your refrigerator. There it is. And
you'll be able to call the number, in the event of a disaster.
And one of these three handsome guys will show up at your house.
There you go.
And fix it.
Fires, floods, storms, new construction, all that stuff. So.
Wow, that was hard to do. All right. Thank you, Joe.
You're welcome.
All right, we'll take a little break. We'll be right back.
Broadcasting from the Paddock Mall Studios, this is WOCA, Ocala, Gainesville, The Villages, 1370 AM, 96.3 FM, The Source.
Fox News Radio, I'm Pat O'Neill. Funeral arrangements set for one of the New York City police officers murdered over the weekend. Rafael Ramos will be buried Saturday. Services for Wen Jianlu will be held when relatives arrive from China.
Mayor Bill de Blasio wants protest and political...